There's a highly dangerous situation ongoing at Indonesia's Ruang volcano, which only 12 days ago produced a destructive explosive eruption about one-third the size of the 1980 eruption of Mount St. Helens. As, once again, a major Plinian eruption is currently ongoing there, which has sent a sustained eruption column up to a height of 25 kilometers or 82,000 feet. This Plinian eruption is seemingly more energetic than what occurred on April 17th, with multiple pyroclastic flows not only sweeping over Ruang Island at the same time, but also near simultaneously entering the ocean. The associated eruption column has already expanded outward like the top of a mushroom to more than 100 miles diameter and is actively raining down large amounts of ash and lapilli. As a result, Ruang's alert level was increased from 3 to 4 and its exclusion zone was increased from 4 to 7 kilometers in all directions. I urge everyone to not only get beyond this radius away from Ruang's summit, but also to immediately flee to higher ground, preferably at least 100 meters above sea level. The center of Tagulanding Island won't be completely safe during the current crisis, but it does mark the safest spot in the context of the overall island. Please wear a helmet or other protective equipment, possibly even put a pan over your head to protect yourself from falling very hot rocks which, on the 17th, had sufficient velocity and energy to punch large holes through metal roofs. Due to Ruang's April 17th Plinian eruption, its summit crater was not only deepened and widened due to the powerful explosion which occurred, but also its summit crater became breached to the northeast. This means that the ongoing powerful eruption is most likely to send its longest-reaching pyroclastic flows in that direction. Since there is a major settlement with only a 1,050-meter gap between the two islands, a pyroclastic flow could easily flow across the water and reach a section of Tagulanding Island. Since pyroclastic flows contain large amounts of superheated debris, if they enter water, they will displace it, and this could generate a tsunami. Hence my opinion, the people should immediately flee to higher ground. Once again, please do not film the eruption near the shoreline like I have seen some people do on Facebook and other platforms, as you are placing yourself at risk. Get out of there! So, why did Ruang seemingly escalate from 0 to 100 once again, just like it did on April 16th and 17th? Simply put, having been largely quiet since April 20th, a major change occurred during the night of April 28th. Beginning at around 10 p.m. local time, this marked when Ruang's quickly growing lava dome reached a sufficient thickness to build an effective plug which caused gases and pressure to build up underneath it. Over the following 22 hours, this pressure continued to build underneath Ruang at a low rate until, at 8 p.m. on the 29th, the volcanic tremor and rate of volcano tectonic earthquakes rapidly escalated. More than 500 earthquakes occurred one after the other in rapid succession due to magma movement, with the rate of volcanic tremor surpassing what was measured before Ruang's April 17th eruption. This pressure at first was released via sustained eruption column at 1:15 a.m. on April 30th, and then a more than 1,000 meter high lava fountain was generated, but even this was insufficient to relieve its pressure faster than it was building at. As a result, a powerful explosion occurred that destroyed this lava dome and began a Plinian eruption at 2:57 a.m. local time. Please stay safe, everyone.